What is good, guys and girls of YouTube? My name is Justin Omoi, and today I want to talk to you guys and girls about customizations for FL Studio. And speaking of FL Studio, I want to show you this real quick. Look at this. This is a mouse pad from the homies down at Inside Audio. They sent this over to me, and I really haven't had a time to make a video or show you guys, and I feel like this one's a good video that would, you know, get a lot of views, and I want to support them. So thank you for sending this over. This is a shortcut key mouse pad. So yeah, look at it. If you can see it kind of better, I guess. You can see it has like F9 and all that stuff. It basically gives you all the shortcut keys you would want to know or learn about to make, you know, life a little bit cooler, easier, and whatnot. Today, I want to talk to you guys and girls about customization and personalization in FL Studio and how to make, you know, appearances change and whatnot. So, yeah, so as you see, I have this little background here, pretty nice, high five. And I also have a Nexus skin. This has nothing to do with FL Studio, but notice how we got so many different, you know, graphic user interface looking skins. Basically looks cool, and FL Studio actually has that too. If I were to show you, look here, it's called theme. You have default and then silent startup, and I guess you know what silent startup does. Yeah, exactly, right? How about this? Let me go ahead and show you the default one. This one's cool. Wow, right? Isn't that cool? What the fuck are y'all doing, ImageLine? Like, fix your shit, man. We want some themes. We don't want this gray bullshit. This is that shit from Fairly Oddparents, those little rectangle head motherfuckers. Fix your shit, man. Make us get some cool shit. We're dying for, like, a customizable thing. You know, give us a way to customize FL Studio, and then they could, like, you know, drop it in there and make it look dope. Like, look at this. We could change the color and make it customizable. Look at that, man. Could you implement this for the theme and then make us allow us to, you know, build our own theme? That would be amazing. Thank you very much. But yeah, back to the theme stuff. With the exception of the actual user interface, like how this is like gray or something, we can't change that. But there's a lot of stuff we could change. Like, for example, we could change, obviously, the color here. If you right-click the name in the channel rack, let me go ahead and expand that. See, it's called backhand. I'll right-click, change color. Boom, we made that a different color. Even in the playlist, you can right-click, change color. Boom, different color. Maybe if I do Alt and P and see there's two things here, maybe if I could, let me see if I could. So let's see, let's say we got all these right here. I'm gonna hold Shift, click. Right click, hold on, rename in color, boom, and look at this. So notice we could check, we want it from green to, I don't know, blue. Hit enter, and look at that, we got a gradient of green to blue. Ain't that tight? What the hell, there's nothing in there. Oh, okay, there we go. You can even change this right here, change color. Put that into purple. So yeah, now we have a purple pattern. Just in case you wanted your pattern to be purple. There you go. Rename in color. Change it instead of purple. Let's make it pink. Hot dark pink. Hold on, you thought we were finished? No. In the playlist, you can also change the color by going here. View. Go to color grid. Grid color. And then we can go ahead and select the color. And isn't that so good? Isn't that amazing? If I had a garbage can, I would throw up in it right now. Like, if we were able to, like, change this color and this color for the two different patterns, that would be kind of dope. But, yeah, I don't know. This kind of reminds me of the Game Boy Color, so I guess it's kind of cool. But yeah, if you want to look like a banana, you go ahead and change the color. And let's pick a default color, which I guess is this one. Kind of looks like it. Hold on, did I say we're finished with the playlist? I'm sorry, we are not finished with the playlist. Because look at this. If I were to take this little Space Invader right here, if I were to take it and drag it in there, beasto! We got a Space Invader picture. How cool! Now this is actually kind of cool, but it's kind of creepy at the same time. We could also take like a, I got this Pokeball PNG, but is pretty much a lot big or bigger than I expected. It would be nice if we were able to see, you know, the grid with this, but, you know. I guess if you want to be cool, by the way, go to here, view, remove background picture. If you want to be cool, I guess you could, like, take a picture of this grid and then edit it in Photoshop and, like, put it on top of it as transparency or something. I don't know, but it would have been nice if we were able to do that. Matter of fact, now that I mention that, let me see if I could do something. So let's say we do this layer, unlock. Sorry, it's not even FL anymore, ain't it, right? You know what I mean? Let's put 75%. Let's see what happens. File, export, PNG. Wow. Okay. And let's see what happens if I take this. I'll put this over here and drag it into FL Studio. Oh, that's pretty much tight. But isn't it so weird? It's so weird. Like, what? Ooh. But it's still cool, but ugh. Oh, I'm sorry. One more thing. Look at this right here. You see these patterns? You can actually go here, view, behind clips, and then you can make them like different things. Like, this is solid. Ain't that solid? Let's go to pattern one, drop that in there so you can see how that works out. And yeah, there's some other view stuff in here, but I like solid. It's pretty solid. Plain. It's pretty plain. Okay. That's actually not that bad when you put this picture behind it. It's pretty cool, but now there's a gap, and that gap's weird. What the hell? There's a whole bunch of shit if you look over here. So that's the playlist, and I pretty much showed you this right here. Bam. Why is there no, like, grid coloring here? I don't know. Right click here. Let me see. Color group. Color selected. Okay, there we go. Color selected. Gradient. So if you want to be cool like that, go ahead and do that. And then the next color, let's make it like that. And wow! Why am I choosing those same two color schemes? I forgot to mention. Well, actually, I didn't forget to mention. But there's different presets for this as well to, you know, change it out. You can make it a single line. So it's a single line. You can even make it look like a Mac where the X button and all that is over here. And there's a little funky image line icon there. Cool, right? Oops, didn't mean to do that. You can uncheck that to get those separators out of there. Recheck it, whatever. Whatever you want to do. It's your life. Edit. So you can have more like panels. Like, let's say we want the arrange button there. And we're done. Let's just click here. And let's just make this, I don't know, tablet mode. Like that. So if you use a tablet, you like shit on the bottom, you could do it like that. You can even go back to default. Go back to here. Default desktop. There. Boom. Go away. You can't recolor these. So, yeah. Too bad. So sad. You could change the size of this. I know that for sure. Size. Compact. Small. Big. Huge. Massive. That's something else. But back to this top bar here. There is a way to move shit around. It used to be better. Well, like, you could actually see things move. I don't know why. Let's say you don't like this bar over there. You like it up here. Bam. There we go. Let's say we want this shit up here. Let's say we want another row. Oh, shit. I guess we don't have another row or something. I don't know. Whoa. We can even move the whole row. Put it there. Let's see if we can put it at the side. Like Photoshop and all the Adobe shit. I guess you can't. That's that. If you want to do with that. You can also right-click this oscilloscope, put it to the spectrogram. You can undo that if you want. There's a stereo for two tracks. That's for the os. Yeah, I'm using mono, so there's no difference. Here's a long version. Speaking of long, let's go back to edit. And make it longer if we want. I'll leave it like that. Oh, yeah, if you want to throw some shit back in here, like, who needs this microphone? Who needs this? But yeah, you could basically customize this the way you like it. And I don't know, maybe we could put two of them. No, we can't. Okay, whatever. Let's go ahead and talk about the mixer because, you know, the same thing goes. Not too much left, by the way. Just if you want, you can highlight, right click, change color. Hold on, right here. And wait, I thought there was a gradient for this. Well, I guess it doesn't matter because you could just take this, go over here, and then Control Shift L, and the colors are there. Isn't that pretty gradient-like and awesome? I think so. Let's go ahead and change this coloring so we get the colorful mixer to be very colorful. And look how colorful that is. You can also just color one by itself by right-clicking, change color, change rename, and all that. So we made that indigo blue. Hold on. We could do stuff here as well. Let's say we want, I don't know, a dB meter or something. You could rename and color this if you want to. Rename color icon, change color. Let's make this yellow because yellow is cool. And look at that. You got a yellow dB meter in your thing. And yeah, I talked about color a lot, but let's also talk about this right here. Because this is something that a lot of people don't know about, actually. They just, you know, leave it like that. Look at this. You could actually adjust this to your liking and have the effects down here just like a Pro Tools. That way you could save space and just remove this piece all over. So, what button is that? Hold on. Son of a bitch. There was one. View. Alternative mixer highlighting. That's to change this shit to white, which is pretty interesting. If you don't like these little wires for some reason, maybe you're weird. It's all right. You can uncheck the routing cables, and it will take off these little wires. Why would you think that? You know what? I've been talking about colors and looks, and I never talked about icons. I'm sorry. I'm so sorry. If you right click, you go change icon. These icons help you indicate different things. If you want to feel ugly, you have this little ugly icon right here. Maybe you want to change this one and use a xylophone. What the hell is a glockenspiel? Okay, we got a glockenspiel. Last but not least, I know I said last but not least just now, but look at this cute little shit in the background. And if I click away, it kind of fades out. And then if I click back, it kind of fades back in. That's something called a dynamic wallpaper. You could change your dynamic wallpaper. They have these that's available. So you have a knob, a metal plate. We don't even a fruit plate. What the ugh, that looks disgusting. Come on, dog. This is like the best one. You also have a browser, believe it or not, just in case you're too lazy to click Chrome down here or something. Here's a browser, and here you could check youtube.com, or you could check any other website if you know what I mean. But I guess they just put it in there just in case, you know, gotta cater everybody, right? And here's a pink background, just a pink one. And yeah, so if I go here again, sorry, if I go to FL Chan LeBay, notice that this color may be different from yours. You might see like a pink one. And you're like, what the hell? How do I change my colors? Don't worry. I'm glad you asked. Let's go to the C drive. I'll just make sure I'm not showing anything. C drive, program files, image line. And I'm using 20.1 beta. I don't know how to get 20. I guess if I open there and whatever. We're going to artwork, wallpapers, find the FL Chan. And here we have background. And this is actually colors that you can select in like Photoshop or something, or if you use a website to identify the hex color. So yeah, let's focus right. FF2400. Instead of using a hash symbol, we use the dollar sign. FF2400. So if I hit save and go here and go ahead and go into view background, dynamic, and I load this again. Whoa, it changed colors, which is pretty sick, but I like my old one. What was my old one? I'll have to check the video. There's also a way to change the size. I think I changed the size of this. No, I did not. So let's say a tiny one is not good enough. What did I just do? A tiny one's not good enough. We want bigger. We want like 800 bigger. Hit save. Do the whole shebang bang again. View, background, set dynamic, then FL Chan. Whoa, up in your face. This is actually more scenic. Is that a right word to say? Scenic? Good. I'm gonna wing it and guess it, but 00FF00. Yeah, buddy, your boy knows his shit. So yeah, you got a pretty little FL Chan. I'm not sure how these images are selected. Maybe it's inside the FL engine and then, you know, selecting a different symbol or letter. Let's say, for example, the knob. Y'all saw the knob just now, right? What if I change this to 20? I don't know. Or 2. Let's see. So let's go view, background, dynamic, then knob. Look at that. The number 20 is there. I wonder if I could write something else. I don't think this will work, but we're gonna try because trying is always, you know. Shut up! All right, so let's see if that works. Okay, no, it does not. But that, apparently that's the wing ding for the word fuck. So as you saw, like a different letter has a different code in it for some reason. But you know, having a number there will show a number, and I guess because they want to show numbers like that. So yeah, there we go. But yeah, that's basically it right there. Let me know what you guys and girls think. Are you going to customize it? And if you have, you know, some sad feelings about not being able to change the colors of the mixer, like, you know, the level, the decibel meter, or even the top here, be sure to let ImageLine know because, you know, that shit sucks. Make themes, please, ImageLine. Make some cool themes. That'll be sick. Let us be able to make our own dynamic background. That would be sick as well. I like the you know, the blurriness, and then come back and it's like not blurry. That is dope. It's your boy Justin Omoi. Thumbs up. Be sure to check out justinomoi.com. If you want some mixed and mastering, hit your boy up. The prices are cheap for a limited time only. And yeah, with that being said, peace. I'm out.